Hello and welcome to CNS Vital Signs. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create remote testing codes as well as manage codes that have already been created. So first, we're going to start at the CNS Vital Signs homepage. You're going to go and sign in and manage account. Once you're at this page, you're going to enter your username and password and log in. So you'll see on the right here, we have a couple of different buttons to choose from, the bottom of which is CNSVS remote testing. So going in here, this is how you access the remote testing page. Now you'll see here a couple different things. On this top half here, we have active remote test codes. These are codes that have already been created and have not been used yet. As soon as a code is used by a patient, these will disappear. At the bottom, we have an area to create a new remote test code, which I'm going to do now. So enter your information for a new patient. We recommend having some type of naming system for patient ID that is not readily identifiable by anyone who may see this page and who is not necessarily supposed to. So once that is created, you enter some simple information, at which point you will be able to select the subtests and rating scales that you'd like this patient to complete in the remote test. So I'm going to start with the 7 classical subtests, and I'm also going to add the Pittsburgh Sleep Quality Index scale. All you have to do is generate the remote test code. You'll see that the new test code we created is right at the top. We have its time that it expires. Every single test code that you create will expire within 1 week of creating it. So it is important to get the test code over to the patient as quickly as possible to maximize the amount of time they have to complete the test. There are a few main ways to get the code to the patient, two of which are to email the code. The first, you can email the code from your own email client. These are things like Apple Mail, Thunderbird, Outlook. I am on a Mac, so if I click this, it's going to immediately open my Apple Mail with a message. You can see here, now I can enter the patient's email address. This is Eric, and here's the message, and you can see that they have the test code, which they will enter when they are ready to take the test on our testing page. You can either send it that way, or you can send it through our dedicated mail server. All you need to do is enter an email address and send the test. But please note that if you do choose to send the email from our server, you cannot edit the message on your own before sending it. And the last way that you can get your patient to access their test is to direct them directly to our testing.cnsvs.com testing site. We recommend that you become very comfortable with the site as well. This is a great backup system to ensure that all patients will be able to take their tests regardless of if they do have problems with their email or not. All you need to do is be able to direct them with the correct remote test code for their patient ID, and they will be able to take their test from the testing site. Going back to the testing site, after you confirm the following, you will see a continue button pop up here, which will prompt a video that has a lot of great information to make sure that the testing environment is standardized and is going to produce great data for your patients. When the video is complete, the patient can click to continue. There's a little bit more information right before they start the test, and there's an enter my test code, at which point the test taker will enter their remote test code that you can give them over the phone. Please note, this is not case sensitive, so this could be, you know, uppercase or lowercase, and it will still work. And finally, once everything's entered, the test taker can just press Start My Test, which will take them to the CNSVS site, and they can begin their assessment. The results will be accessible through the View Reports button here. Now you can see that this, because I chose not to complete the test, we have a non-completed designation here. And if this does happen, and your patient does need a new test, all you have to do is go back to the CNSVS remote testing area. You will see that test code is no longer available. And if we need to create a new test, we can do so. Make sure to click the retest button just to confirm that this is someone that does need a retest because they had a computer error or a user error or something along those lines during the test process. Enter their information again, generate new remote code, and send it again, and they will be able to access another version of that test that you created for them. If you do have additional questions about this process, feel free to contact us at support@cnsvs.com, and we will do our best to update you as quickly as possible. Thanks.